I was supposed, this is what I was supposed to do. What I was supposed to do was get ahead of schedule and send you all a survey so that you could answer a bunch of the questions so that I could then present the data to you. Okay, that has never happened. So what I ended up doing was I went out to iPads, I went out to the EDUCAUSE core data survey, and I went out to your websites. And I put together some information about us, not about the ACS, but about the schools that are represented in this room, okay? And I thought that I would start to share that with you, and then we could begin talking about what I'm missing, what other questions we have for each other, just to sort of set a foundation, because over the next day and a half, if you're using something that I want to find out about, then I have a chance to do it. I just had a great conversation with Joe about Four Winds Digital Signage, and I've learned a tremendous amount tonight, and it's all worth it now, you know, just from that single conversation. So those are the kind of things that we're hoping will happen. So the very first thing is, how many students do we have, right? So this is just our typical undergrads. So under 1,500, four schools, and again, I took this out of iPad, so it might be not quite right, but this is what iPad says. There's three schools, 1,500 to 2,000, and there are four schools in the over 2,000 full-time undergrads. Interestingly, those four schools in the over 2,000 have a decent population of part-time students as well, and those numbers aren't reflected here. And I see Carrie's face because she's saying, we don't care over 2,000. If you look at iPads, yes, we do. So we are very close to, we're very close to that number. However, if it's counted by institutional research, that's where we are. But it's interesting that it's those four schools that have big part-time programs. And some of these programs are really quite large. You know, Richmond, I think, had 700 students to this number because of the part-time program.
Well, we have a whole school of continuing studies.
Right, you have a whole school of continuing studies. We have an entire school devoted to adult evening part-time programs. So we add 300 or something full-time head to this. So there are, but none of the schools that are under 2,000 actually have those part-time programs. Your full-time number is just about your number, at least according to iPads. Full-time faculty. So under 100, Birmingham Southern, 100 to 150, 150 to 200, 250, over 250. Trinity was like 264, and then Richmond jumped to 400, which is why I put the number 400 there to remind myself of that. So their number of faculty is really much larger than the rest of us. So then if we look at student-faculty ratio, again, this is according to iPad, so it's not quite perfect, because we here at Rollins will say that we have a 10 to 1, and according to iPad, we have a little bit over 12 to 1. So, but, you know, we're all small schools, right? I mean, even if you say 14 to 1, well, come on, 14 to 1 is still a pretty great faculty to student-faculty ratio. So we really can't complain about that. What I really wanted was number of instructional technologists in your schools, but I just couldn't get that number. Right? I couldn't get that number. So I used as a proxy your total IT staff, and then I compared that to your faculty. So faculty to IT staff ratio. Birmingham Southern has 11 total IT staff, Hendricks has 12, Center 13, Rhodes 13, on down the list. And then the next number is the faculty to IT staff ratio. The mean of those numbers is 7.4. So you can see Swati, you're at 4.9, so you have this marvelous faculty to IT staff ratio.
I think I counted people who shouldn't have been in that.
So I took these out of core data. I took some of this out of core data.
We're going to turn around and say there's a whole debate about those of us who have large library
information.
That core data, we just
make things up. It's too hard to try to suss it all out in the way EDUCAUSE wants you to report it.
Yeah, I agree. I try to use core data. You know, core data asks, like, how many people do you have in this and how many people do you have in that? And we all put in 0.5 and 0.3. And I couldn't pull out enough information from that to make it worthwhile. So if we actually said, how many people do we have in what we would consider instructional technology? Birmingham Southern? One. Hendricks?
Two.
Two. Center?
Two.
Two. Rhodes?
Technically zero. We don't have instructional technologists.
Okay.
Thank you for allowing me. I'm wondering.
Okay. Southwestern?
Two.
Two. Swanee?
One and a half.
Okay. Furman?
Three.
So. Rollins? Four. Davidson?
We have three. Plus, we have a video specialist that's part of our platform.
Yeah, right. That's it, right? Sometimes we just don't know, right, where those people go. Trinity?
Oh, can I add? We also have a fellowship. So every year we have a Davidson recent grad that's
pretty much around.
Yeah.
It's oh, great.
Pretty much part of our staff.
Oh, that's nice. Trinity?
One, maybe two.
Richmond? Yeah, I have seven.
Well, right now it's two, so.
Yeah. So a variety, we have a great variety across what we are. Wasn't this interesting? Look at this. I was amazed. Now, Richmond, 6-7 years ago, you started with Sakai. I can't find Sakai on the website anymore.
We had Blackboard and Moodle both for a while, and we dropped Moodle, strangely enough, but it was never fully supported by Blackboard.
And Sakai was gone.
Faculty are just happy with Blackboard. We have 88% usage and about that same satisfaction. Yeah. It's crazy. We're not sure why, but it's...
Greg?
We're actually Moodle, Trinity.
Oh, Trinity's not?
Yeah, we're Moodle.
Oh. Okay, sorry about that. Okay. All right. Canvas? No.
Huh? Not yet.
Not yet? We have an unfortunate pilot going on in Canvas. What?
Yeah, we have a pilot.
You have a pilot in Canvas going on? Yeah, we have a pilot in Canvas going on too. We hope it does. I hope it does. I don't know about those guys. I don't know. I'm doing my best to get it. But I was really surprised at the consistency in this, right?
Yeah.
You know, I really
Why do you want to kill it?
Because I don't want to support you.
Oh.
And I don't want to deal with the change management of moving all my faculty over to Canvas. I mean, that's the honest answer. What about you?
Well, we have faculty doing it on their own. The University of Texas is moving to Canvas from Blackboard right now, totally moving into our campus. So,
UCF did that here.
Yeah.
They're moving to campus?
Yes. Yeah. They will be totally moved by the end of this calendar year.
This raises some questions about when we think of cost containment.
Yeah.
This raises some questions about whether the ACS, how many people do Moodle on their campus? You have it on your servers?
Yep.
Okay, and then how many people host it with somebody? Because this certainly leads to a question of whether the ACS or could host Moodle for everybody, right? Right? That would be cost containment. And the big thing with Moodle is having the programmers to actually create really nice Moodle sites. And together, potentially, the ACS could hire several Moodle programmers and create some really nice Moodle instances at our schools. That might be an area for cost containment. That hit me when I looked at this. And if ACS did that, I might be interested in getting my campus to start thinking about Moodle.
I don't know what the problems were, but Midwest Instructional Technologies Center, one of the regionals, had started doing Moodle, that same kind of thing. At that time, it was partially to provide piloting spaces, since Moodle spaces wasn't around and all that. But they were trying to move to a semi-cost model for people to move their production houses over to Moodle. And it's a eventually nightly. I'm not sure why that failed, but it's something to probably look at. Part of it might be the era, but I would probably want to look at that before coming back to that model. Just to make sure that all the pitfalls are looked at.
I think if you're looking at your path through the classroom, far more CIOs wanting to keep things on their own campus than thinking that way down. So I think there are a lot more prone to moving it elsewhere. I also went to the EDUCAUSE core data to try to get some sense of what we use in terms of educational technologies. So these data come from the core data service. Far and away, our schools support the LMS both technically and with training, right? That was the big one. The way the core data service does, it asks, like, do you do it broadly, you know, somewhat, minimally, are you just experimenting, those kinds of things. So I tried to pull out those things that most of the schools in this room said they did broadly. And the LMS was by far the biggest one. We claim that our courses, that 62% of our courses actively use the LMS. So that range was from 21 to 90. So we have a school in this room who said that 90% of their faculty are using it actively, and another school who said 21% are using it actively. So we have a lot of range. Faculty use 70%, so 70% of the faculty, 62% of the courses. 37% of the faculty only use the basic features, and 51% use advanced features. Those are supposed to add up to 100, so some of us CIOs in this room couldn't do our math. So, in terms of support services, we provide instructional technologists and we provide students to our faculty to help them incorporate technology into their teaching. So that's something that we all do. It's done broadly. And we provide training to our faculty, both group and one-on-one individual training. So that's something that we all do. The tools or methods that we use broadly, again, the LMS, blogs, we use those broadly. Something called collaboration tools, which for EDUCAUSE was defined as Google Apps and SharePoint. So we do that broadly. Information literacy we do broadly, and something called interactive learning. Who would not mark that? Interactive learning. I don't know who would mark that. But anyway, we all do that. All right, so here's what we don't do. Boy, this was an interesting lesson. This is, very few of us are doing this. Maybe we're experimenting, but we weren't prepared to say that we were really doing. Distance learning and online courses, okay, that one makes sense to me, that we're not doing that. E-portfolios. Wow. So, Amy, are you talking about e-portfolios? Amy's going to give a talk about e-portfolios. We're just starting that here. So, Amy's going to give a talk about that tomorrow or Friday. E-textbooks. We're not using e-textbooks. This one's interesting. What? You could say broadly, you might be experimenting with them on your campus, but you're not using them broadly. And that was where I pulled the data. Facebook and Twitter, not being used in the classroom.
Where are you using Twitter some?
You're using some? Okay, your CIO did not mark this. What?
Sorry, the students are using that.
Yeah, this problem. But the faculty are not using it in their teaching. Gaming and simulations, we're not using. That's really too bad. I mean, I think we all know that gaming and simulations.
lot of, we have a lot of learning benefits for our students, but we're not using mobile apps. We're not using much in the way of mobile apps in our teaching and learning.
Some people in music are.
In music?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay. Wikis. We use the crap out of wikis here.
Yeah.
We use so many wikis, it's remarkable. Right? Jessica's going to tell you. You're going to tell us wikis?
No, I'm talking about WordPress.
You're talking about WordPress, but we do wikis with WordPress.
Correct.
So Jessica will touch on wikis a little bit. We use a lot of wikis. Yeah, okay. I meant lecture caption. We don't do lecture caption. So I thought that was interesting.
How many people are looking into lecture captures fairly seriously?
Yeah, we are.
Okay.
Yeah.
So not yet, but.
Yeah, that takes me to my next set of slides. I actually wanted to create a slide like this. I had created a slide like this that said lecture capture, because we're using MediaSite, and I wanted to know what other people were using. And then I saw that we all said we weren't using it, so I took that slide out. We also do a lot of web conferencing, and we're using WebEx for that. What is everybody else using?
Connect.
Adobe Connect?
Skype.
Just Skype?
We're using WebEx.
Using WebEx too?
Google Hangouts.
We're using a program called Blue Gene. Oh, yeah.
That
with
Google Hangouts.
Right, with Google Hangouts. So
none
of the Blackboard people in the room are using Collaborate?
No.
Do you like it?
We use it just for kind of program sociology.
You just don't have enough to justify it, so you use Connect.
So you use Adobe Connect?
Yeah.
Okay, that's all I